It's Tech Lid, and we're bullish. The stampede is coming, baby. In this video, we will be talking about Sndl Growers, the ticker symbol for this stock, SNDL. We're going to take a look here at an article from the investorplace.com. I'm not going to read the entire article in its entirety. Make sure you do that. Do a quick Google search. You can read the entire thing. I'm just going to go over a few quick things here. Why Sndl Growers is the best cannabis bet. This is the headliner. Sndl is debt-free and has a strong balance sheet, giving Sndl stock plenty of opportunities. I repeat that and will highlight that. Plenty of opportunities. Uncertainties in the federal legalization of cannabis are taking a toll on Sndl stock. Sndl spent most of the time below the dollar level for months. Its brief rally in June is an exception. At the time, Reddit's Wall Street Bets tried but failed to take the Canadian cannabis grower stock higher. Where will Sndl shares go from here? First of all, anytime I see any article mention Reddit as a main cause of a stock failing to go up or even getting all the credit for going up, it is laughable and it's insane, really, because they act like Redditors are the only people investing in this stock. I'll let you know, Sndl was long on my radar before the whole Reddit Wall Street thing, and it was on many people's Wall Street. It was in a lot of people's radar before this whole Reddit Wall Street slash meme stock thing. Remember, the media tries to twist things in a different way, and they try to push and create this narrative. So the narrative they have for Sndl is that it is a meme stock, that it's kind of worthless, that it's only going up because it will get pumped. No, Sndl is a debt-free company that has plenty of growth potential. Don't let them stop you now. And as I have always preached here, Sndl under a dollar is a complete steal. Legalization delays hurt Sndl. So basically the whole thing here is how legalization of marijuana is not legal in the United States yet, not in all 50 states. When this does turn around, however, we will have Sndl probably being one of those stocks at the forefront of the entire movement. Right here it says, Senate Majority Leader Chuck Schumer released draft legislation on July 14 that would legalize weed. This marks the rough start on the debate for taking away federal penalties on cannabis. 18 states already fully legalized marijuana and 37 permit medical marijuana. So 37 of them permit medical marijuana. Look, I don't know about you. I don't know if you're good at math or not. There's only 50 states. 37 permit medical marijuana. It's only a matter of time before we get most of the states to do it. I'm talking about between 46 and 49, and then there's always this one weird state that wants to be left out. But the fact of the matter is, I believe that all 50 states will permit medical marijuana, and then there will be fully legalized states, maybe not all 50, but close to all 50, close enough that the whole thing could practically be considered legalized. Look, before we continue with this video, just a quick disclaimer. I am not a financial advisor. Always make sure to do your own due diligence and research when you invest in any type of market. When you do the homework and you do the research, you will come out winning. Bank on it. Right here, we're going to take a look at the opportunity for Sndl Growers. Sndl has a massive 448,000 square foot indoor facility. It uses a small batch at a scale module growing method to maximize operating profits. Furthermore, it packages its goods at the lowest possible cost. By managing output using a data-driven consumer-centric approach, It voids unnecessary waste. No other competitor runs the business at this detailed level. So right there, that is absolutely good news for Sndl growers. Look, they have a freaking humongous indoor facility, right? And they use small batch as a model to produce their products. We're talking about models that are being cared for. And at the same time, when you get small batch, there's more care into the product. It's not just some insane wholesale type thing where they're just packaging their goods and getting it out the door. No, Sndl is using high quality here, and they're also packaging their goods at the lowest possible cost. So at the end of the day, you might not get this insanely fancy packaging from Sndl, but you have to know they're cutting costs and maximizing profits. At the same time, even though you might not get that super fancy stuff, you're getting a real quality product because it is at the small batch level. So always keep that into mind. Keep that in consideration. Sndl's unmatched moat suggests that the stock could build an uptrend from here. When the company reports quarterly results in August, it could squeeze short sellers for the third time. Previously, Sndl stock rallied in June to around 150. In February, the stock spiked to 396, albeit only for a day. And then here, it also talks about the risk of Sndl growers. So, of course, you know how I do with my channel. We don't keep nothing from you guys. I keep it 100 with you. I keep it real with you guys. Right here, we don't promise anything. Oh, about the promised land, you're gonna make it forever. No, this is the stock market. People get wrecked every day. But the thing is, you have to know how to mitigate those risks. There is a risk in investing in any stock. There's other channels out there telling you to invest and that you'll become rich. No, you gotta work at this thing. You gotta do your research and you gotta work hard. That's how it is. Sndl has unfavorable stock scores that investors should not ignore. The company does not have a long enough history of strong results. This is normal for a growing firm. So this is one of the things you definitely have to keep in consideration as well. There's not enough history with Sndl. As I suggested, you could read the entire article. It will give you more details about that. So look, Sndl growers, I've always preached it, and I'm going to reiterate and repeat it. Under a dollar, you're golden, baby. Let's take a look at the price of Sndl growers here. This is the past month. Sndl is down 10%. Today, for the day, Sndl is going for 80 cents currently. Of course, depending on when you see this video, the price could be higher or lower. It is down nearly 2 cents for the day, which is good for 2.19%. I always say that there are swings with this thing. Even in the past 5 days, look, Sndl was down 1.51% overall, but it was coming from that high of 88 cents. And today, we saw Sndl growers start at 82, get as low as 79 cents. Here's the thing for you traders now. I know a lot of people are not always long on every single stock. So for the traders, I think right here, for anyone that got to catch this at 79 cents, right here is a good buying zone. 79 cents, I think you can ride this back up to 85 to 86 cents. I know it doesn't sound like a lot, but when you have a lot of money invested, because this is so low price, for those swing traders and those traders, if you want a quick profit, Sndl gives you that. But keep in mind what the article said. Those short sellers usually end up getting burned. But as you know, Tech Lit Bull always keeps it real with you guys. There are many different scenarios that could see you profiting. You could either be diamond hands and hold for the long haul. That's for the real win. But a win is a win, and the traders, they know that if they get in low and sell a few cents higher, that is a win. The stock market is not about selling at a loss. It's about selling for profit, regardless of short traders or long-term traders. I'm sick and tired of people saying, oh no, they gotta be long traders because the stock won't go up like that, blah, blah, blah. No, the stock will go up regardless. The stock does its thing. The price comes at an agreement for the traders, the investors. Everyone's at an agreement. Some are willing to buy Sndl at over a dollar, and some will not be willing to touch it at over a dollar. It all depends on the investor and their exit strategy. So do not try to shame anyone for their entry point. It is what it is. Everyone will get in at their own set price. I think for traders, 80 to 82 cents, you could ride that back up to around 88 cents. Look, make no mistake about this. If you think that Sndl is not going to reach 86 plus cents, you gotta be kidding yourself right now. Thing was freaking nearly $4 in February, kept going down, we had dollar swings, went back to cents, went back up over a dollar, cents, back to a dollar. Look, you guys get it. I'm not messing around with anybody, I keep it real. Here we are at tipranks.com, Sndl stock forecast and price targets. On the low end, they have 70 cents, on the average, 75 cents, and their high is 80 cents. That is actually where we are right now. So according to Tip Ranks, this could be the ceiling. But of course, as you know, all of those news catalysts and everything going on, I think Sndl is just beginning. We have a rating here of a hold. That's the consensus rating. 2 holds, 0 buy, 0 sell. AKA when they tell you to hold, they really mean don't sell the thing. So if everyone holds and people keep buying, you already know what happens with the price. So Sndl, I think, is set up here and it's not doing bad, not at all. Right now, it is an underperform. The smart score, as you know, is a 3. The sentiment is bearish, of course, over the course of the last month. I showed you the percentage numbers. Sentiment is very negative for Tip Ranks investors. So they're just not completely on board with this. But as you know, the super catalysts, they are waiting in the background. And you want to get in while everything is in motion. You don't want to get in once the news is out, the good news, and then the price skyrockets and you're just trying to catch up. You want your position in there already right now. Of course, I can't tell you what to do with your money. That is all up to you. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to give it a big thumbs up so we can have more eyes seen on this video and move that YouTube algorithm. Tech Lit Bull here, always keeping it real with you guys. If you didn't like the video, thumbs down, it's all good. The news ain't gonna stop, baby. If you haven't done so already, please do consider subscribing to the channel as it helps a great deal. Hit that notification bell so you can stay up to date, informed, and notified. Until the next time, peace and love to the Tech Lit Legion.